Welcome to my channel. Today I've got a video for you all about my movie and mostly actually music, merchandise, clothing. I feel like that was a very long description. If you can hear something making weird noises in the backdrop, that's my coffee machine. Coffee. I love coffee. Anyway, another thing I love is the point is music and movies. So I thought I'd just show you some of my merch and just, you know, yeah, just tell you what I like about the movies and the music and like where I got the stuff. I always love watching this kind of videos because it's usually stuff that people are enthusiastic about. And it's always fun to hear people talk enthusiastically about stuff. At least I think so. So yeah, I hope you'll enjoy. So, intro is done. Coffee is done. We're good to go. I've just moved to the side a little bit so I can insert a clip here of the shirt I'm wearing so you can see it in full rather than this tiny little bit here. So yeah, this first one is a Van Halen shirt. It's really cool, and maybe I should start with an explanation actually about one thing. I'm not one of those people who hate on people who wear band tees of bands they haven't listened to, because you know, you do you, whatever, I don't care. But I personally would not wear a band tee of a band that I do not know or like. Also, by the way, if I look like crap, it's Friday. I worked Monday to Friday this week and it's after work now, and yeah, even though I enjoy work, I mean, it is a 40-hour work week, so excuse this. Anyway, but yeah, about the shirt, yeah, that was my point. I don't usually buy stuff of bands that I don't listen to a lot. Before acquiring this shirt, I did already listen to Van Halen just in the category of, you know, all the random rock and hard rock music of the 70s and 80s that I like, because I do like the style of music. But for example, I would not wear, that was my point really, I wouldn't wear a t-shirt of a band, for example, that I totally don't know, because I might be wearing a band tee of a band that I would absolutely hate if I would actually bother to listen to the music, which would be rather awkward. Such was not the case with Van Halen though. I actually got this shirt, I didn't even buy this shirt to be honest. I got this from a photographer I often work with as a makeup artist, and he was like, hey, do you like Van Halen? And I was like, I vaguely know them, yeah, they're cool. So he gave me this shirt. It's from Bershka and it's so freaking cool. Like, it looks destroyed. Like, it has fake cigarette burns here. It has fake tears in the side and all. And it's like fake cut shorts and all. It's so cool. I love it. It looks so completely rock chic and cool and awesome. And I really adore it. I also love the colors in it. The print is really, really cool. And like, it is just such an awesome shirt. It is quite warm actually, despite it being so short, so if I actually want to wear it in winter or even autumn really, I do wear a shirt, a longer shirt underneath it so my belly doesn't get cold. But yeah, I really, really love this shirt. It's so comfy as well, and because it's so loose, I don't actually mind it being tighter around my neck. I don't usually like that. But yeah, I really, really like the shirt, and my favorite song by Van Halen, by the way, is Dreams. I think it's called Dreams. I hear it in my head. But like, I won't sing it for you to tell you which song it is, because my singing voice is so terrible that YouTube would not only demonetize this video, it would take it down for fear of traumatizing people. Yes, it's that bad. But yeah, I think it was called Dreams, and you know, they have a lot of famous songs, and yeah, just, I love their music, and I also really, really love this shirt. It's just sort of funny that I loved this shirt before I actually really started loving their music. It's just how life goes sometimes, let's just call it fate. Yeah, another fun fact by the way, I had no idea that Van Halen, the person Van Halen, was actually Dutch before he died, and it was in the news that he was originally Dutch. I'm Dutch too, like, I had no idea, like, seriously, I live under rock, I live under a rock, apparently. Yeah, that's also just a fact of life, apparently. But yeah, so that was shirt number one. And next up, let me actually drink some coffee. Douwe Egberts coffee. Like, they have coffee at work and it's decent. I mean, it's caffeine. It's drinkable caffeine. But it just doesn't have the flavor. Like, it's free coffee, so, you know, I'm not complaining. But, like, it's not Douwe Egberts and I love Douwe Egberts. Anyway, this was not about coffee. This was about some of my other obsessions. Clothing and music. And some movies. Yeah. Anyway, next up is my collection of Bowie-themed clothing. People who've been following me for longer on my channel won't need an explanation on all the 5 million reasons, long list it could be, of why I really, really, really love Bowie. Like, his music, movies, just how he came across in interviews and stuff as a person, like things he said, just ideas he had, and like, you know, personality, stuff like that. He was awesome and I will always really, really admire him. So that also means I have heaps of clothing with either his name on it or his face on it. Or both. Yep. Anyway, first of which is this shirt, which I also actually got from the same aforementioned photographer. If you're watching this, thank you. But yeah, I got a lot of clothes from him, really. But yeah, anyway, this particular shirt, I really do feel like this is one of those shirts where it's like, they have this style of shirt and they just printed a lot of like band names, people names, movie names, whatever on it. It's pretty generic, but I do really love the style. Yeah, so it's really, really, really cool. It looks really rock chick like again. One thing I will say about the shirt is wear a sports top, because, well, it's actually the same with this thing, although this is long sleeves. But if you go up with your arms and, you know, chances are it's just going to fly up. And if you're like me right now are wearing a sports top underneath, it won't matter because it's not a bad thing if people see it. But if you're wearing either nothing or a really frilly bra, you might not want to show that to like the entire world and outer space. Even the aliens shall be watching. Maybe not, but still, you know, you might want to play it safe and actually wear something underneath it that you wouldn't mind being visible to strangers. So yeah, that's a thing. But yeah, I do really like this. If it's colder, same as with this shirt, I will wear something underneath it that's a bit more covering. But in summer, this is also really lovely because it's so airy. And because it's so airy, I again don't mind the fact that the neck is a little bit higher, because it's like basically wind just flows right through this. And yeah, the style is just really, really cool. The next shirt actually is also really, really cool. It's also a Bowie shirt. This is like the full collection of the Bowie stuff I have, really. Well, the shirts. Which, now, like, my vinyl collection is down there. Comparing it to that, my clothes are a lot cheaper than my vinyl collection. So really, I could just buy more clothes, because I'm not spending that much money on clothes compared to how much I've spent on vinyl. Like, let me just put it this way. Some of the albums down there are like 70 euros or 80 euros. On their own. I could have bought a new car by now if I would never have bought vinyl. But I don't regret it because I love listening to vinyl. But yeah, anyways, this shirt was actually bought at New Look. Yes, I actually purchased this one myself instead of getting it from someone. It's a rare thing, I know. But yeah, anyway, I love the rainbowy effect in it. Rainbowy Bowie shirt. That was a stupid joke, sorry. But anyways, but what I particularly like about it is that this particular image, people who also love Bowie will, you know, probably notice this, but this is like pre-Ziggy Stardust. For those of you who don't know, Ziggy Stardust is like the whole character where he had this like circle on his head and no eyebrows. Yes, he's totally started the trend. And you know, that's something you see often printed on shirts and all sorts of merchandise. Same as the Aladdin Sane makeup with like the lightning bolt across his face. You see that a lot, but you really don't see this image a lot because it's pre-Ziggy Stardust, so before he really, really, really got famous. And yeah, I think that's really cool because it is an image you don't see very often, yet they just executed it so well on this shirt with like the rainbow against the black, and it's really, really, really cool. So I really adore that shirt too. Next up is a shirt that I actually bought in London, and I should have known better than to buy a cheap white shirt because the neckline is totally yellowed and it's from a weird brand. And it's extra small and it's more like a medium because it's a weird size. Anyway, the picture is really cool. It's Bowie during the... I'm trying to not cover my mouth because that sounds weird in the microphone. But yeah, it's Bowie in the glass spider era. Which is basically the like second half of the 80s, approximately. yes, I could totally tell that by his hairdo. It's really, really, really cool. He's so awesome. But yeah, anyways, I really, really love this shirt because he looks really, really sexy in this shirt. And like, you know, the leather, like jackets, and then like no shirt beneath it. And like, wow. He looks really hot in this shirt. And also, it was actually... It was technically, well, it was my first souvenir I bought when I went to London the first time. I mean, I'm not even counting the poncho I bought because it was raining like hell and I discovered that the coat I was wearing was not water resistant at all. So yeah, technically the first thing I bought in London was a poncho. But the first thing that I bought because I actually wanted it was this shirt. I bought it at Covent Garden at one of those little stands there, and you know, like it's not official merch, obviously, but it was like only £5, and it's really, really cool, and it reminds me of London, and I totally do regret buying a white shirt because the material is so cheap that it stains absolutely everywhere, including armpits, and I'm really thinking of just cutting out the image and putting it on a different shirt, or just hanging it on the wall or something. But nevertheless, the image on the shirt is really cool, the memory attached to it of going to London for the first time. I actually vlogged that, it was the vlog that I did with my big camera that I'm filming with now as well, when I went there with my dad. But anyways, the memory is just really cool too, and yeah, this is also just one of my favorite pieces of clothing overall. Next shirt is also, again, a Bowie shirt, and also this one was also a gift from the same photographer I mentioned a couple of times before. But anyway, this is the very famous Aladdin Sane image with like a lightning bolt. But what I do like about the shirt, by the way, I think it's, yeah, it's divided by H&M. I don't think they still actually sell this, but you know, it is really, really good quality for H&M. It's very stretchy, it's very soft, it doesn't stain. It helps that it's black, because black is usually doesn't stain as quickly as white does. It should just be, you know, illegal by law for me to actually wear white clothing, because it's always a disaster. But yeah, I really like the shirt because it's like, well, one thing I love about the design, they made the image grayscale and really, really light, and that against the black, and then with like the, I really hope you can see the effect, but like the matte gold of the lightning bolt and the lettering, and it's just, it's a really, really cool design. I really like it, and the shirt is also ridiculously comfortable. Like, it feels like a pajama, even though it looks very nice and like fitted. So yeah, I really, really love the shirt as well. Now, we're actually done with the Bowie merch for now. We're moving on to AC/DC. And actually, by the way, all the items I'm going to show from this point are from large.nl, which is actually emp.com abroad. They actually have like websites in multiple countries. So this might actually all still be available, is what I'm trying to say here. Everything is size small, with the exception of the hoodie that I'm going to show last. That's medium. But yeah, first up, AC/DC. This shirt is really, really, really cool. They actually have this design with multiple bands, with like the ombre gray to dark gray, blackish. I really, really love it. I love how the waist is very nice, and like I love the distressed look of like the cuffs and like the neck part and the underside and all. And it looks really cool. I also think the design is pretty, pretty awesome. With like just the coloring and like the fadedness yet boldness and like guitarist, and like it's a really, really good, really cool shirt. This particular shirt is Let There Be Rock, which is a really cool song. My favorite AC/DC song is actually Highway to Hell. Yes, I know it's very basic. I mean, everyone knows that song probably. And I totally love yelling it along, screaming it along in the car alone, of course, because again, I don't have a good singing voice, and I only sing when I'm alone in my car, because then I'm not torturing anyone with it, because no one can hear me anyways. Yeah, I'm nice like that. And yes, I'm totally the third person, by the way. And when I'm going to work at like 4:30 in the morning, I totally yell along to music. It might be AC/DC, it might be Metallica, but it could also be ABBA or the Beatles. Like, I really don't care. I just love yelling along to music when I'm alone in the car. But yeah, anyway, this shirt is just another one of my favorites. Also, by the way, I forgot to mention it with the Bowie shirt, but my favorite Bowie song is actually, it's a tough choice, really. I really, like, if I'd have to pick one, it would probably be All the Madmen. Look it up, it's really, really cool. But I also love Loving the Alien, and I just, well, my favorite album is probably the Hours album, which actually has neither of those two songs. Yeah, they're just all so cool, and I really can't choose. But yeah, anyway, with AC/DC, it's Highway to Hell. Anyway, back to the AC/DC shirts. This one is actually a tank top. Again, this is a pretty basic tank top that they have with multiple prints of multiple bands and stuff on it. But I have this one with AC/DC TNT, also a really cool song, 1975. I totally know what it says, because I wouldn't be able to read it, like, mirrored in a viewfinder at all. I can do that with letters, but not with numbers for some reason. But anyway, this one is really, really nice in summer, obviously, because it's a tank top. But what I also really love about it is the contrast. I really love contrasting prints. And like, this is pure black and pure white. Like, seriously, it almost, like, how I see it in the viewfinder now, it almost glows. It's so, so, so cool. I also love how 3D it is by this being so thick and opaque, and then there's like the thinner lines underneath it almost. It's really, really cool. I will warn you about one thing, which is if you're like me, a between size of like small and medium, if you want this to be a little bit more like soft and not very tight, I would go for medium. This is a small. And the first time I put it on, I was actually kind of worried that it wouldn't actually fit. Like, it fits, but it's tight. It's really tight, which I like. But if you don't like your clothes being that tight, then, you know, you might want to go for a medium, because this is a pretty tight fit. And that brings us to the end of the music merch. Now we're moving on to movies, which is exactly two items, and they're also both sort of the same movie, and also bought but because of one character. Avengers, and specifically purchased because Iron Man. I really, 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 really like Iron Man. As in, I actually think Robert Downey Jr. is really hot. I'm only attracted to like unreachable movie stars and musicians who are either dead or like, you know, twice my age. It's no wonder I'm single as hell, is it? Anyway, yeah, but like the merch is really cool, and yeah, I love the print on it. It's just really, really nice and vibrant. One thing with these trousers is though that I wish they would have actually put elastic in the, like at the ankle part. I totally forgot what they're called. I've had a long week, okay? I love my job, it's really fun, but like, yeah, it's tiring at the end of the week. Anyway, not even really tiring, really. Like, I don't know. Like, I really enjoy my job. But then you're like completely focused on that, and then you're focusing on something else, and you forget basic things like how the bottom of trousers are called. Just me? I don't know. Anyway, but yeah, I prefer it with jogging trousers, with like sports trousers, if they're actually tight around my ankles. These are very loose, which reminds me more of pajamas, but very thick, because they do actually have this fleece lining, which is really, really nice and soft and warm. But anyway, they are hollow though. This part is hollow, so I might actually put elastic in it myself, so it just fits more snug around my ankles. But that aside, I really do love the design of these. And then finally, this last item, which is also, again, a Marvel item. This is a hoodie, a zip-up, based on the Quantum Suit from Avengers Endgame. I'm still not over the end of it. I will keep complaining about it forever, really. But yeah, anyways, it's a really cool item of clothing. There's just one downside on it, about it. Yeah. Brace yourselves. It has no pockets. I know, it's terrible. It's tragic. It's like a disaster. It's like a crime against humanity, really. But it has no pockets. And it's really like, it's terrible, but it has redeeming qualities. Such as the fact that it just looks really, really, really freaking awesome. I love how the hood just falls over your head. I love how it's just like, I just love how the hood looks. There's something about it that I just really, really adore. I don't know what it is. It just looks really, really cool and almost cartoon-esquely perfect. It also has the Avengers logo on one of the sleeves and on one side of the chest. I almost knocked over the deodorant bottle off screen. That's what the sound was, if you may have heard it. Anyway, I personally don't wear this while actually doing workouts, because I want to, you know, not destroy it and don't want to make it sweaty, because I really like how it looks. But you totally could wear it while doing sports, because these parts, the white parts, are really, really nice and airy. But it's also nice and isolated. It's just a really, really lovely piece of clothing. And that brings us to the end of this video. That is all the clothing I had to show you and the stories I had to tell. I really, really hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, if you did enjoy this video, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to see more, you can always subscribe to my channel. I actually mostly do makeup tutorials. Obviously, they're a little bit more complicated than just eyeliner and concealer underneath my eyes. Like, seriously, I didn't even use powder, because this is totally what I wore to work as well. And it was like 4 a.m. when I did my makeup, so obviously I didn't really make that much of an effort. But yeah, anyway, I hope you enjoyed watching this video at any rate. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!